Hi everyone, today I'm going to explain about virtual clock. Okay, first take an example. Okay, suppose example. Okay, if you want to run the synthesis, what you will do, suppose this is your block. It has some clocks, clock A and suppose clock B and some suppose A, B, C like that, D, E, F like that. Output G, H, I. Suppose think like that. This is your design. This is one suppose top block. You have to run the synthesis for this. You have clock A, clock B, and ABC is the input, and ABC, DEF is the input, G, H, I is the output. Now you want to run the synthesis for this. What you have to do? You have to write the create clock constraint for this. This also you have to write create clock constraint, what frequency this will work, you have to tell like this, like that ABC is working on which clock, like the which clock, right? Suppose A is working on clock A, you have to write the set input delay constraint for clock A, clock this A with respect to clock A, set input delay constraint, right, with respect to B, with working on which clock, clock B, like that you have to write the set input delay for ABC for clock A. Set input delay DEF for clock B. Suppose DEF is working on clock B, then set input delay constraint you have to write for DEF. Like that, EGH, G is working on clock A suppose. You have to set output delay constraint you have to write for this. HI is working on clock A. Then you have to write set output delay and with respect to which clock also you have to write it. Already I explained set input delay and set output delay in previous class. Those things you have to create clock constraints also I explained. You have to go through that class and coming to this concept. I am repeating the thing. Suppose I have clock A. Tool want to understand this clock is working on which frequency. That's why I have to write create clock constraint for this clock A. Clock B, I have to write the create clock constraint which frequency this clock B work. Then ABC, as per design I know that ABC working on clock A. That's why we have to write set input delay for this clock A, clock B, clock C with respect to clock A. Because this ABC working on clock A, right? It means the input delay means you are telling that from other block to this how much delay is there, that you are telling that set input delay like that. DEF is the working on clock B. That's why set input delay constraint you have to write for DEF. Suppose G is working on clock A, set output delay you have to write for G. Here HI is working on clock B. That's why you have to write set output delay constraint for clock B for this block. Now coming to what is virtual clock. Suppose think that there is no clocks here. This all will be generated inside, there is a combination circuit. Suppose this is connected some combination circuit, then it is going connected here like that. This input is connected, then this input hard, and this two input is ANDed, and this one is connected here, this one is connected here. Think like that, some combination circuit is there. But when you are running the tool, synthesis tool will expect set input delay, set output delay constraint for this block. I am repeating, here there is a combination circuit. For this top, I have ABCDEF is the input. And GHI is the output. Now there is a combination circuit. I want to find the delay of this combination circuit. How I can do that? Okay, if you give in to this tool will expect the constraints. What constraint tool will expect? This ABCDEF, you have to write set input delay constraint. For GHI, you have to write set output delay constraint. Set input delay constraint, what? Set output delay constraint, already I explained in the previous class. Go and look into that video. Okay, now set input delay. What is set input delay constraint? Set input delay, some delay value from which clock need to work, you have to put it. That is suppose clock minus clock, clock A suppose. Then you have to write the get port name, you have to write VA like that, you have to write. What you have to write? Set input delay and what is delay of that one, max or min, you have to write it here. Minus clock A, get ports A like that I have to write. It means that A from other block to this A, how much delay is there, that we are putting here. Okay, now I don't have clock concept here. There is no clock at all this for this block. What I have to do? You have to do create clock, which period you want to put it, which waveform you have to, you suppose as per frequency you can put it here, you put 10 minutes, 05 you can put it here. Minus name slave clock, get ports will not be there. If get ports is not there, this clock has, this slave clock has a virtual clock. If get port is there, that port physically exists, that's why that is not virtual clock. What is virtual clock is, our design, sometimes we have to use one dummy clock to calculate the timing for the design. That is, slave clock is a dummy clock. Now what I have to put in clock position, I have to put slave A. But this slave A is, slave clock is physically exist in the design? Answer is no. That's why this slave clock is the virtual clock. Okay, any point of time, you can use this virtual clock. It means that some of the inputs is there. Suppose ABC, other E is there. E is there. ABC working on clock 1, DEF is working on clock, suppose clock 2. Then E is not working on clock 1, clock 2. You can create the virtual clock, and using that clock, this E can be delayed like that. You can write it. Set input delay using virtual clock, you can write it. Okay, virtual clock, there is no physical port in the design, but you have to do that. You have to do the calculation with respect to that clock. That is, the clock is virtual clock. Virtual clock, anytime get ports will not be there in the design. You can't write this line in the constraint. It means that the slave clock does not, that port itself not there, but you can tell that ABCDEF is working on slave clock. How you are telling that? First create clock, create tens, waveform 05, minus name slave clock. That's it. Slave clock, tool assume that slave clock is one clock. That is virtual clock. Virtual clock means that port is this one is not exist in the design. But ABC you can declare. Set input delay, minus max, you can put some, what delay you want, you can put minus clock, slave clock you can use. Get port A, you can use that. Now tool will tell that how much delay from this to this. Suppose, okay, I will not write the constraint. Then what tool will do? Tool will expect the set input delay constraint for these lines, set output constraint for these lines. Otherwise, tool will not run. Tool will fail itself. That's why you have to create one dummy clock. Using that clock, you have to write input delay constraint. Use for that, you have to write output delay constraint. That's why what is virtual clock is, any point of time, one signal, any some set of signal, you don't know which clock it is working, you can put dummy clock is save clock, and using that clock, those ports are triggering like that, you can write it. It means that the slave clock is not exist in the design. Virtual clock means that will not exist in the design. Okay, thank you. If you have any comments, please add the comments down, I will reply back. Okay, thank you.